Earlier this year, I decided to stop being a leech on society and get a job. Unfortunately, my parents didn't consider YouTube to be a valid career path, and so a few weeks after I launched my channel, I was forced to start looking at more traditional job opportunities. So, where do you think a legal adult who dedicated the majority of his high school career to studying physics and spent the last 3 summers as an intern in research labs would end up? That's right, Chick Fil A. The funny thing is, though, that the application process for Chick Fil A was, in many ways, more intensive than the application process for any of the labs I had worked at, or even the university I'll be attending. In addition to an online application that required my resume and school transcript, I had to pass 3 separate interviews in order to be considered for a job. For context, that's 3 more than my university required. My first interview was at 4 p.m., and I woke up just 2 hours before that, watched YouTube videos for 1.5 hours, realized I had an interview that day, and then set the land speed record trying to make it there on time. I did eventually arrive just as my interview was about to start, but as I sat down, I realized that I had completely forgotten to look up what questions they'd asked me beforehand. So I think it's fair to say that I bombed that interview like I was a Enola Gay. It went on for nearly 30 minutes, but that was only because I spent at least 10 of those minutes just sitting there in silence, trying to think of a response that wouldn't make me look like too much of an idiot. In fact, the only reason I got the second interview at all was because I met a friend who worked at that same Chick-fil-A the next day and begged her to tell the manager that I wasn't actually as dumb as I seemed. Whatever she said, it apparently worked because 1 week later, I found myself at the same table talking with a franchise owner. I had actually prepared for that interview, so it was largely uneventful until I got up to leave, realized I didn't have a ride, and walked 2 miles back home because I was too afraid of looking weird going back into the same restaurant after my interview. The third interview with the regional director was also largely uneventful, with the exception of 1 question he asked. At the very end of our conversation, he asked if I was comfortable lifting 15-pound boxes. For those of you who haven't watched my clickbait alpha male video, it's important to know that I spend a large part of my free time lifting. So when I was asked this question, I saw it as the perfect chance to alienate my interviewer and show him just how big both my muscles and my ego were by responding, "I'll do you one better than just 15 pounds and lift anything up to 350. So I was very surprised when I got an email 3 days later telling me not that I was a massive prick who had no self-awareness, but that I had instead been offered a job as a cashier. Either way, the next step in becoming a CFA cashier was filling out the appropriate employment forms, of which there were 2. So how long do you think it took me to fill out 5 pages of legal documents? Well, guess again, because it took me nearly 3.5 hours. Here's an example of why it took me so long. On the Maryland MW-507 form, it asks you to list the number of tax exemptions you qualify for. So how do you determine the number of exemptions you have? Well, the question asks you to turn to page 2 to find that. And what does page 2 say as the first step to determining how many exemptions you have? And I quote, "Multiply the number of your personal exemptions by the value of each exemption from the table below." So I have to know how many personal exemptions I have in order to find out how many personal exemptions I have. What the heck was the comptroller smoking when he wrote this? And filling out the forms wasn't the only thing that was going wrong. In order to collect my paychecks, I had to enter my bank number. So I went to my bank's website and tried to log in, only to be told that my account didn't exist. What? I knew I had set up an account just a few weeks ago, and yet now it wouldn't let me log in. So what was the problem? Well, it turns out that the account I had set up last week was for the bank's secure message center, which was completely unaffiliated with the actual online bank account. Fine, whatever. I still had to set up a new account, so I filled in all my personal information, clicked submit, and was notified that I should check my email for the next step. And what do I see when I open my email? This. Sorry about that. Anyway, I don't think I have it in me to ever fill out employment forms again. See, if you want to help me not starve and also pay for college, probably speech therapy considering I can't speak right now, consider liking and subscribing. It means a lot.